in the script, the creature is not called a creature, is referred to a black membranous fluid. And when we got Kevin Yeager in, a very gifted special effects person, and in my experience, there are two kinds of people who do special effects. There are the kind of kids who sort of grew up dissecting frogs and you know, reading Fangoria from the time they were 8 years old. And then there are the kind who are like Kevin Yeager, who went to art school and wanted to be a painter or a sculptor. And I hired him. He hadn't done a whole lot of stuff at that point. He'd worked with Rick Baker. And what really sold me on him was he had a series... He worked for me on Nightmare 2. He had some pictures where he made up a person to look aged. He took a guy in his, you know, was about 30 and aged him to look about 65, and then took him out in the park and took a whole bunch of pictures, and people just related to him. And when you looked at the pictures, he actually looked normal as opposed to, you know...
Like, latex.
Yeah, as opposed to, now, of course, the state of the art's gotten a whole lot better. But I felt that Kevin really was more of an artist, and that's why I used him on this show. So we wanted to come up with, well, what is a black membranous fluid? How are we going to do that? So we came up with the idea, and I don't know, again, whose idea it was. Could have been mine. Probably was mine. That it ought to be like a parasite. Because, you know, it inhabits you. I don't know, maybe it was Kevin's idea. It's hard to tell. Everybody's ideas get mixed up, and then the director takes credit. So I'll take credit. It was my idea. That it should be like a parasite. Also that it should be black. The idea that it was black, I felt was very important, because one of the things in the script that I thought was extraordinary was that at the very end, when Lloyd transfers into Beck, he's made out of light. I mean, everybody thinks an alien is being, that a good alien would be like whiter in color, but the idea he was actually white light, I thought was an extraordinary concept. So then Kevin came up with various sketches, which I and everyone else associated with the production looked at, and we finally agreed on a particular creature. One of the decisions that we made was that we only needed to see it once, and it was a very, very good decision, because if you saw it a second time, it would be redundant. And what happens is that when you see it the first time, it's done so well that subsequently, you already know what's going to happen. You can anticipate that you're going to see it, but then you don't actually have to see it. And it's just the very economical way of handling the whole thing.
Doesn't hurt your pacing either, because then you can always sharp cut away from the other scenes, and you don't have to, you know, pause to right. see this thing go from one mouth to the other.
Right, right, yes. Yes, it certainly helps the pacing not to have to see it as well. The way that Kevin did it was he made two dummy heads. He made molds of both people's heads. And there was a new technology that just came out. There was some new kind of latex. And the heads that he did were so extraordinary, particularly Bill Boyette, the old guy. The head was so realistic, and he had put in like tiny little hairs and that it was Bill Boyette. It was not a... I mean, you looked at it, and it was... You expected it to start talking. Mm-hmm. And in fact, when Bill saw it, he said, "Get it out of my sight, because I can't look at that thing." It was frighteningly realistic. By the time we finished, after about 8 hours of cramming that creature into the mouth of that particular... dummy puppet. The puppet was pretty much torn up and shot. But, and in fact, that was the very last thing that we did on the show was that it was more properly a second unit shot. So we cut down the crew a little bit, but I felt very strongly about filming that. When I did Nightmare on Elm Street, which was a much lower budget, we had a second unit going. And I found that the second unit, a lot of stuff was unsatisfactory because they would shoot an effect as an effect. Whereas it wasn't an effect, it was a scene where something was happening. In other words, they'd film a hand where nails are suddenly bursting through the flesh. And they'd kind of film this great mechanism where the nails would come out through the flesh. But I'd say, wait a second, there's a person who's in pain. That's what you're trying to portray. So I try to shoot these things myself because maybe I make a 5% difference, but, you know, that's enough to help. Or, you know, I'll do it just slightly different because the second unit never quite does it the way you would do it.
That's the truth.
And it's always slightly or more than slightly unsatisfying. And so I felt strongly that I should do this because it was a character thing.